Hey, what's going on everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another Launchbox News video. Today, we've released Launchbox 13.4, and just like all of our awesome releases, we've got some fixes, improvements, and some new features. With 13.4, we've really focused on the speed and usability of Launchbox itself, and yet it really shows with this new release. Now, the first thing I want to show off here is really awesome, and it's probably one of my favorite features for 13.4. And that's the new pop-out or detachable games detail feature that we added here. And in order for this to work, the Launchbox theme will need to be updated. The default is always going to work for us, but if you wanted to use something like one of my favorites, Big Details, just make sure you update it. Varen has done so. And if you take a look right up here, we've got a new button. We can pop this out. So now we have our game details separate from our Launchbox, which is really cool. And we can actually snap this. We can scroll through it, find our achievements, all the information we need. We can go through our videos, screenshots, box art directly from here. Let's move over to a different game. And as you can see, once we pop it out, it'll go full screen for us, gives us all that information. And now we're not just working in a small little area or a little windowed area to check out all of our game details and achievements. We've now got a full screen view and we can scroll through here and find out all of the information we need to know or want to know about each game. We can also resize this so you can set it up exactly like you want. If you like those 3D boxes, we can actually mess around with them right here directly from the game details window in full screen. So we've got that big box here. And it also snaps to the left or the right hand side. Personally, I'm really liking this new feature. And keep in mind, I do want to mention it again, that the theme needs to be updated in order for this to work, at least to get that pop-up button. The default theme is always going to work, and you can go into the theme downloader inside of Launchbox just to see if everything's been updated, or you can always check out the forum under our Launchbox themes download section. Obviously, a lot of work has gone into this new update, and of course, we've got some more fixes and improvements here that I kind of wanted to touch base on. One of the main new improvements here is just overall speed of the interface when it comes to Launchbox. Now, from here, I'm actually on my all section, got a bunch of games here. But as you can see, I mean, this thing scrolls so much quicker. Even while it's caching, you'll notice that you'll get those images a lot faster than you would before. And you'll also notice that the speed in which we can swap between platforms has been significantly increased. I mean, these just populate immediately now. As you can see, loads right up for us. And I do want to mention that right now, this is actually running just on an APU. I don't have a dedicated graphics card. This is a Ryzen 4000 series APU, so we're using integrated graphics here. And I know in the past, I did have a little trouble kind of scrolling through, had to wait a second. But with this new update, everything just populates much faster, and it's just a much smoother experience overall. Adding to the overall experience, we've also updated the way badges are populated. In the past, if we favorited something, or let's say we completed a game and we've checked it off here, we'd have to reload the page for everything to show up. But as soon as I favorite this, you'll see it pop right up. So I've got that new badge listed there. And I need to make sure I shut this off after I do it, but I did want to show you completed. So with this, we can just go right through, favorite all of our stuff, and we don't have to reload this page in order for it to all show up. Really cool new feature. Definitely a welcome improvement. As a lot of us already know, one of the easiest ways to get MAME games up and running on your Windows PC is using Launchbox with the MAME importer. This has been totally updated. It's going to be a quicker experience. And if you're not familiar with this, we do have a full tutorial. I'll leave a link in the description. The process has been really streamlined here. And with this new improvement, a MAME import went from like 7.5 minutes or maybe even 8 minutes down to 1 minute or under, depending on how much data you need to grab for that game. So it's much quicker. Now, when you're importing 2000 MAME games, it's still going to take a while because that's just really how it is. I mean, if you're importing 2400 games, you can expect to wait a little while. But if you've got new MAME games that you want to add to your collection, that process has been cut down significantly. And the last thing here with the MAME importer are the import filters. We use a number of third-party files to determine different things about MAME games, like categorization, what kind of controllers it supports, what genre, if it's two-player, three-player, four-player. And this is going to really help to filter games while doing a full-set import. As you know, for a long time, we've had kind of our categories that we could go through, but all of the third-party files that Launchbox uses to determine the different things about your MAME games have all been updated. We've also combed through a full set, and we were able to manually filter out even more non-game ROMs. So when you do an import, or in the past when you did an import, you might notice that, you know, everything went smooth, but there's a few games in there that aren't really games, or it just imported a couple files that weren't necessary. With this new update, all of that has been alleviated. You're going to have a quicker import process, and it's going to be much more accurate. There is a lot more that's gone into the 13.4 update. If you're interested in checking out the full change log, I'll leave some links in the description, but that's going to wrap it up for this one, and we really appreciate you using Launchbox. If you've got any questions, let us know in the comments below, and definitely check out our forum and keep an eye on the YouTube channel because we've always got new stuff coming for Launchbox and Big Box. But that's it for this one. Like always, thanks for watching.